Now that I've explained each one of the tarot cards in detail to you all, I want to talk about starting your tarot journey. Now, the first step in starting your tarot journey is basically deciding that you want to go down this divination path. So the first step you're going to take now is choosing your deck. Now, in some ways, the first step may seem the hardest. Basically, you've probably researched knowing there's quite a few different tarot decks. Now, how can you make an informal choice, especially at the beginning? The most popular one that you see most people show is the Rider White deck. It is probably the best as a first choice. Though there are reasonable similar ones, the BOTA deck is a good alternative. Many of the introductory texts on tarot, such as those by Eden Gray, Rachel Pollack, Elaine Connolly, and Robert Muller, and A.E. Waite himself, include the images from the Rider White deck. So it's like the book that I've read from you is showing you the Rider Waite deck. The Rider White deck and the BOTA, the BOTA decks, are sometimes referred to as rectified tarot decks, meaning that they have reinterpreted the earlier styles and themes, as well as introducing additional concepts not found in the earlier decks. To this extent, they serve to remind us that many details included in the tarot are comparatively recent origin, and that some of the symbols and images we are now so familiar with were not actually featured in the earliest tarot decks at all. The Rider White deck is currently available in three sizes. Now I've seen this one in a very, very small one, about that big. And I know there is one where it's attached to a keychain as well, but I can't remember where I saw that one. You can get them in the medium, which is about this size, and there are slightly bigger than that as well. And then you can diverse from that and go into the different sort of decks. Like, I've got an actual fairy tarot deck, which I'll show you in another video, and it's got different symbolisms than what we went through in the previous videos. Now, once you've got your deck of tarot cards, you're going to want to be protecting your pack. Now, once you've chosen the tarot deck that suits you, try to become as familiar with it as you can. Handle cards frequently, shuffle them regularly, and build a rapport with the cards so you imbue them with your personal energies. Now, this is what I've told you in a previous video. This is what I do. I touch my cards every day, I shuffle them every day, and I infuse them with my energy. Taking time to reflect on the individual cards even before you have studied all their specific symbolic meanings in detail. So basically, like I did in my previous videos, you can go back to those videos and use them as to study the cards, help you understand each individual card. When you have finished using the cards on any given occasion, wrap them in protective silk, cloth, or purse. Gold, purple, mauve, and dark blue are ideal metaphysical colours for this purpose. Tarot silk bags and purses are often sold in New Age shops, but I've known people to make them as well. For storage, select an attractive, well-made wooden box. The box should be used only to store your tarot cards and for no other purpose. Now, I'm going to say I'm very controversial on this. I don't store mine in a bag. I have mine in my witchy drawer next to my bed, on top of a bag of my crystals. And basically, I do that because every day I go into that drawer and I'm able to touch them every day, and I'm able to grab hold of them. So I'm going in and out of that drawer all day. The box should be only used for the store of the tarot cards and for no other purpose. When you want to put your cards away, wrap them in their silk covering and then put them in the box in a secure place where they won't be disturbed. This way, you will honor your tarot cards and help to reinforce the feelings that they are special. So that's that bit. I'm just going to go into a little bit more for you. Now, staying true to yourself, it is important to remember that you will need to stay true to yourself when reading the tarot cards. This will enable you to interpret the illuminating and often very profound themes the cards bear. The tarot cards will serve as a trigger for your intuitive insights and enable you to develop your psychic and spiritual awareness. As you begin to explore the universal and archetypical themes of the tarot, they will gradually be manifested to you through your own intuitive understanding. If you are performing a reading for someone else, this is particularly important. The person seeking insight will be depending on you to maintain your integrity and your own sense of inner knowing. So basically, that's important to know. Now, you need to learn to relax as well in order to access your powers of intuition. It is essential that you become centered on the task at hand. In the first instance, this means you will need to learn how to relax. The last thing you want to do is project your own anxieties or tensions onto someone else's during a tarot reading. So basically, you don't want to be having things on your mind and give someone else a tarot reading, because then you're infusing it with your issues and your concerns. There are many ways of relaxing, and you will need to find one that works for you. A simple and easy approach is basically meditation is what I use. The important point to remember is that relaxation will provide you with a sense of openness and inner stillness that will allow you to center your awareness. Now, the way I center myself is through meditation that I learned through Akida. Once you have achieved this sense of feeling focused and fully aware, you can concentrate on using your intuitive skills to explore what the tarot cards are telling you. Now, finally, the next thing I'm going to tell you is keeping a tarot journal. I mentioned this in one of my previous videos. As part of your tarot reading routine, it is a good idea to keep a journal in which you can make daily listings. A tarot journal is rather like a dream journal, a record of your psychic and intuitive inspirations. You may receive intuitive inspirations that you will want to think about later. A certain symbolic reference may flash into your consciousness and will require further exploration at a later time. Now, setting up a tarot journal, basically, it's just using something like this, pages like that, date, time, type of spread, major or minor pack, question, and then list the cards in the order that of the spread, say card one, card two, and you do that, and then you write down what card it is, then you write down the interpretation of the spread, and that way you are able to go back, see what the spread said for you. If anything significant pops out at you that has come up, then you'll be able to have a good record of that. So basically, yeah, that's what I want you to learn first on the tarot. And I hope you've enjoyed the video, and blessed be everybody.